Titus, the former professor from Department of Mathematics, and today he'll be talking about the decision theory, an introduction in the context of pandemic situation. So now I hand over to Dr. Stephen.
Right. Thank you very much, Dr. Sanjay Datta, for organizing this webinar, and I am really thankful for all the participants who are participating in this seminar. And what we are going to do here is what I used to do for 15 lecture hours for the non-mathematics students, the decision theory. I am giving the gist of it in a very practical manner without going into too much of jargon in 1 hour. So let's see how it goes. All right. So I'm sharing my screen now, and I think you can see this. And let us learn this decision theory in a practical way in the context of this pandemic. Right. So, you are what you decide. Your decision tells something about you. And here, we are all called to be a leader if you are a teacher. Now, in McKinsey, they gave 3 criteria to be a good leader in times of uncertainty. 1, live through a crisis. All of us are living through the pandemic, therefore that is satisfied. 2, you are able to make tough, unpopular decision because it is the right thing to do. I'm sure we are all doing that. Okay. Meeting friends, not meeting friends. These are 2 possibilities. And we chose not to meet friends and not to go and, go for vacation. These are all tough decisions, but these are the right thing to do. Washing hands, wearing masks, whether we like it or not, these are tough decisions and we took it. Therefore, we have done 2 of these criteria. Therefore, they say, these are the things that develops in you. What you decide makes you a leader. Now, a simple preview, a decision theory is a cusp of major disciplines such as mathematics, statistics, behavioral economics, business. Okay. The whole thing started with mathematician John von Neumann and the economist Oscar Morgenstern when they jointly developed game theory. And we will be using these to make the decisions. Okay. Now, the further development, if you want to go some major milestones, in 1994, John Nash was given the Nobel Prize in economics for his development of the game theory to economics. Now, Nash equilibrium, many of you would have heard about it. Then, in 2005, Thomas Schelling and Robert Oman were awarded the Nobel Prize for economic sciences again. And 2012, Alvin Roth and Lloyd Shapley also were awarded Nobel Prize for economics based on the theory of application of game theory to real life situations. All right. Now, they have Schilling published work based on the military strategy, arms control, energy and environment policy, climate change, nuclear proliferation, terrorism, organized crimes, foreign aid and international trade, conflict and bargaining theory. So game theory is applied everywhere. Okay. And the Schelling, okay, was the first one to analyze the infinitely repeated games where why some communities are very cooperative over time. That is a just brief preview. So where we are now, let us start with it. Okay. I want you to imagine you to be a man of 45 year old, whoever you are, you just imagine. And you have a wife, 42 year old, and your son is 15 and your daughter is 9. And you had cough for 7 days, which you managed with cough syrup. Cough did not subside. Finally, you developed fever and your wife is coughing too. Now, what are the choices you have got and what are the decisions you are going to make? Just write down in your notebook, just as an exercise. what are the options you've got and what decisions you are going to make. I'm going to give you just 30 seconds time, just right now. All right, that is just one taste of what you are pressed with and so on. Now, we will go step by step into what are the different components. Now, watch this. I'm sure you recognize this, this bureaucrat. She is a Bengal bureaucrat and she died of COVID. And what she was doing, she was overseeing the movement of migrant workers housed at a transit camp in Tankuni, after they arrived in Shramak special trains from different states. She was doing her duty and she contracted COVID. Just ask yourself, what was it in her? What was it in it for her by doing her duty? That would give us, what do you mean by payoff? What did she want? What was it in it that she could give her life? Now, you would recognize this man. So he's Arun Singh, a civil defense volunteer, worked through the day. He single-handedly fed for 3,000 people who were stranded, who were in the construction work, and he contracted COVID, all right? And then he also paid it with his life. On the day when the 12th standard board exam results were there, in which his daughter appeared. So, what was it in it for him? Why did he do what he did? What was he getting out of it? Is it money? Is it recognition? It is fame? Whatever. What is he getting? Now, soldiers, 20 soldiers lost their life in Indochina border. When we hear about all these people who really sacrifice, the supreme sacrifice, we admire them. But we let us enter into their skin. What is it that made them decide to be what they are? What is that is called payoff. All right. The motivating force is called the payoff. And we'll come to that. This is the simple question is, what do I want? What is it in for me? For what purpose? For example, you can ask yourself, for what purpose you decided to attend this webinar? What is the purpose? All of you would have something in your mind. Just note down. And if there is a purpose, can you quantify it? So payoffs are simple numbers on numerical scale, and once the unit associated with these numbers, for example, it could be doctors, policemen, dollars, rupees, whatever, degrees, number of papers published, once they are determined, many decisions become clear cut. And knowing who you are and what you want are the critical things in making the right decision. Okay. Now, once you decide, this is where I need to make a decision, create a list of options. Very often, especially in crisis, people just jump at the first option that is offered to them. They don't even think whether this is the reasonable alternative. So create a list of alternatives. First, you decide that there is a decision point, and then create a list of alternatives. And then we come to a first major criteria. It is called admissibility criteria. Whether an option is admissible or not. Very simple. There is two, you know, health policies, plan A and plan B. Plan A is cheaper, plan B is costlier. But the facilities are the same, the amount of coverage in the hospitals and so on. You will easily rule out plan B. It is inadmissible, whereas A is admissible. That's what we are talking about. So when we choose an alternative, it not only solves present problem, but it helps you to solve the future problem. That kind of a thing, you need to say whether this criteria, this option is admissible or not. So let's go to a simple example. In Bangalore, three assistant sub-inspectors died of COVID. All right. And this from different police stations. And you are the police commissioner, let's say. What will you decide? All right. So the department, police department, has created fear among other policemen across the city of Bangalore. So what will you decide? Option A, since it is an essential service, let the policemen continue doing what they are doing, and testing can be done every 3 days. That is one option. B, close down all police station and police personnel will be on rounds in sanitized vehicle. Option C, all the vulnerable persons need not report to duty. You choose, you become the police commissioner and choose A, B or C. I'll give you some 30 seconds. Then I'll tell you what is the actual decision which is made. All right. Now that you have chosen, all right, what is your payoff? What did you want in the decision? Okay. So, for example, what the commissioner wanted was for the service to continue, the number of healthy policemen is the payoff. You need to maximize that. Number of healthy policemen is the key factor. Okay. So, my decision should make sure I have the healthy many policemen. All right. So what he decided is this. This actually happened in Bangalore. The police commissioner Bhaskar Rao, he ordered all his personnel over 55 years to stay in home quarantine, and others to set up shamianas outside the police station so that there is a fresh air. There is no closed place where the virus can be overloaded. So shamianas outside the police station to deal with the public. Wonderful decision if you keep in mind that it is the number of policemen, healthy policemen I need for the whole thing. Now you understand what the payoff is. Next is minimax criteria. Minimax criterion is in the worst case scenario. For example, right now we are in a worst case scenario, a crisis. All right. So how to minimize the risk? That is the meaning. Minimize the risk so that you will maximize whatever you want. So it is a risk we are minimizing. It happens in the crisis situation. All right. For example, now the economy is contracting. People are worried about losing their jobs. So they reduce their spending. So when they reduce their spending, the production stops because the demand stops. So businesses are concerned with making sure whether they will be still in business. So therefore, everybody is looking at this crisis. Okay. At this context, the decisions are this one. All right. Now, this actually has happened in India. Now, recently, a state government has been grappling to manage the sudden surge of COVID case in the last 2 weeks. Sudden surge, therefore, it's a crisis. A city in India had just 581 COVID-19 positive cases in June 11. A month later, the number of cases in the city is 16,862. 581 to 16,862. So now, suddenly it has raised up. As a chief minister, suppose you are a chief minister, what are your choices? Just take 1 minute and write down what are your choices and what will be your decision. Okay, a minute is up. I'm sure you would have written many, many things. And actually what has happened, I'll tell you, this happened in Bangalore. And the Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa announced the lockdown in Bangalore from July 14th to July 22nd. All right. As per the experts' advice, while appealing to the people to strictly follow social distancing and mask wearing norms. This is a crisis situation. It is shooting up. So the Chief Minister did the right thing by just putting a break. Let's at least stop this, you know, spread by 1 week of complete lockdown, just to give a chance for the entire mechanism and the machinery to, you know, recuperate and move. All right. So this is minimax criterion. So first one is admissibility criterion. Next is minimax criterion. Third one is base criteria. Base criterion involves the long term. Okay. Minimax is very often the present. Right now there is a crisis. I need to do something about it. Whereas a base criterion, in the long run, what do you do? Especially about investment and many things. All right. The base criterion involves selecting the alternative that will produce the greatest long-term gain. So base is long-term. We need to remember that. So here there is an example of a roulette table where there are 38, you know, numbers you can choose. And when they roll the ball, if it sits in the slot, the number which you have chosen, you get 10 times the amount. 35 times the amount. That is, in case you put 10 rupees, you will get 350 rupees. If you lose, that 10 rupees is gone. So you need to find out what is the expected value, and that is given by the probability of winning into what you win plus probability of losing into what you lose. And if you sum it up, you get minus 53 paise. In the long run, you are going to lose, not gain. This is one of the main reasons people say, and our stories and many of our literature says, gambling is bad, because scientifically you stand no chance in that sense. So, all right. So again, in the clinical trial, you know, this is the, they use the Bayesian criterion. See, the sensitivity of the test kit is sometimes 80%, 90%, 99% and 99.9%. What is the meaning? The 80% kit can tell somebody is COVID positive when they are not. Okay. So, or the other way about. So there could be false positive. Now, therefore, when you look at base criterion, the experts came up with the kit should be at least 90% efficient. 90% at least. And then they also said, to avoid the pluck the loophole, you need to test two times. So that is applying the base criterion. Whether in practical life it is possible to test two times a person and to get that kind of a sensitive kit, that is a different story. But in the long run, that is what will help. All right. Now let's give one simple example. You are investing. You are a good saver. You invest 5,000 a month in a systematic investment plan in a mutual fund. Last June you started, and right now because of COVID, your investment is minus 16%. What you invested, has the value has reduced. What will you do? You are looking at the long term. So A, continue the current investment. B, stop the current investment. C, shift your investment to debt fund or bond fund where you will, you are sure your risk is very less. All right, what will you choose? We'll take 30 seconds and you just choose, and then let's know what's happening. Okay, here also what we are going to ask is, it's up. You will be asking, what do you want? What do you want to maximize? All right, and in the long run, what would help you? And many of you have punched in, you will continue the investment, which is a good idea, because right now the same amount, with the same amount, you'll be buying more units. Therefore, it's in the long run, it will help you out. Great. That's great. That is base criteria. The last one is the maximax criteria. Maximax criterion concerns, it is make hay while the sun shines. or strike when the iron is hot. Okay, there is when the opportunity comes, grab. That is Maximax criteria. You maximize whatever you want to do. All right. So this is right now. You will see even in the crisis situation there are opportunities. You will realize that. Now watch what is happening around you. Now you must be recognizing this. Right now, almost all the countries are working on vaccines. Right? This is a great opportunity to produce vaccine, and Oxford vaccine, led by Sarah Gilbert, is leading, and Russia is telling we will release the vaccine next month. Okay. So now, whoever releases first is going to make a great amount of name, fame, or you know, service, whatever it is, whatever they are looking for, their payoff will become maximum. That's what they are looking for. So watch that and watch the next one. They are also looking at the Glenmark. They are also looking at cure. They are saying they have produced a drug. It is 103 rupees per tablet. And they are saying you need approximately 122 tablets for the treatment. Therefore, it is 12,500. So you can understand what Glenmark wants. What is their payoff? They would like to get the maximum in this time, right? Whereas watch what is happening. An MP complained about the poor people cannot afford this much. It is too much, the pricing. He complained. Therefore, the drug regulator is asking them to explain the money. What is the cost? Okay. Now, what the MP wants, his payoff is, in this case, how to help the maximum poor. All right, in this crisis situation. Whereas here, the company wants how to make the maximum money. Whatever. The payoff can be different. Because of that, the different decisions. So these are all Maximax criteria. And similarly, you see Biocon COVID, it is 8,000 rupees per vial. Okay. It's a psoriasis drug, which they are trying for this, for this, and they're saying that's a great success. So these are all the opportunities where all the pharmaceutical companies are jumping in to make the maximum of whatever it is. And the Oxford, they are saying, we are going to make this vaccine available. We are going to make non-profit way. Even in the non-profit, they do get maximum something. They do get the name, they do get the recognition, their company is running, their workers are fed, all right? So many things are happening. So always, what do you want is the main thing, okay? So therefore, we have seen four criteria. It is admissibility, minimax, worst case scenario, base criteria, that is the long term, and the maximax. When there is an opportunity, strike. All right. Now, in Israel, they are saying they have found an antibody that neutralizes the coronavirus even among infected. So this is the news. All right. Suppose you are in Israel, prime minister, or one who is making the policy decision, what options you will have? Okay. So use only in your country and remove all restrictions and mobility in your country. That's one option A. Option B, make the discovery a gold mine by exporting it to the other countries. Option B. And C, make it non-commercial and heal the world. What would be your choice? I'll give you 1 minute time. Yes, many of you are going for B and C, okay? And C, most of you, that's great. So this is where cooperation or vindictive, all right? The using, because you are having this information, and whether you are going to use it for cooperation or you are going to use it to punish somebody, all right? So there are some conspiracy theories which says, you know, this virus has been given so that one country will take the advantage, other countries will really collapse, their economy will collapse, they will take, that is vindictive kind of thinking. Whereas we will supply the vaccine to everybody, let the whole world be well, that is good for us, good for economy, good for everything. That is called cooperation. All right. So we haven't touched too much on it, but that is it. All right. So in summary, there is admissibility criterion, there is minimax criterion, base criterion, maximax criterion, acquiring and use of information, very important. That is basis of all the decision you are going to make. Equilibrium solution, we haven't touched it. You have heard about Nash equilibrium, but we haven't touched it. Cooperation or vindictive, just we mentioned it. All right. This is in summary, the entire idea. Now I want to ask you a question. And I am going to leave you with this question and two case studies, okay, for you to think. Because I want you to go with something solid, something that you can do, something that is positive. All right. So what are your decisions regarding face mask, social distancing, hand wash? Just take a minute and write. What are your decisions? Once you finish that, second part is, they also, we have heard a lot of information about how to boost our immune system, right? And they said, what are the healthy food and everything? So what are your decisions regarding that? A, hours and time of sleep. What are your decisions right now? The food you eat. And what type of exercise and what time and how much time you are going to exercise. I'm sure you noted it down. And what are your decisions regarding your profession? Because most of the teachers and everybody, office has become home, all right? And the teaching, for example, you know, the face-to-face teaching, classroom teaching has become almost impossible right now. And we are all, you know, resorting to online webinar, online teaching, okay? What are your decisions regarding that? What are the opportunities? What is the long term you are going to gain? Put all these parameters in. What is admissible? Now, minimax criteria. What is your long term, what you will get in your profession? And what is the opportunity right now you have got? Decide a few decisions regarding your profession. Great. Now, I want you to see this.
Now we have amazing video to show you of a rescue in Paris. An immigrant from Mali is being called a real-life Spider-Man after he rescued a child dangling from a balcony. Look at this. You can see Mamoudou Gassama, that's his name, scaling four floors, pulling himself up from balcony to balcony until he makes it to the four-year-old and pulls him to safety from midair. I'll just give you a moment to get to that point. Now, CNN affiliate BFM TV reports that French President Emmanuel Macron has invited him to the Élysée Palace on Monday to thank him personally. Listen to how Gassama explains his feat.
We came here to watch the football match at a restaurant. I saw a lot of people yelling, cars were honking. I got out and I saw the child who was about to fall from the balcony. I like children, so I will hate to see him get hurt in front of me. I ran and I thought of ways to save him, and thank God I scaled the front of the building to that balcony.
Okay, now watch this. There are a lot of bystanders. And here is a man, he says, what does he want? Very clearly, he says, I like children. I don't want the child to get hurt. And therefore, it is very clear there is a crisis here, how to minimize the crisis. And in the long run, what will happen to the child? What he doesn't want is very clear. and he moved without even thinking. And that opened up a lot of his desires and dreams to settle in France has come true. He used that opportunity. So this is what the crisis. Are we going to be bystanders or are we going to do something positive? That is one. Second, this is a 92-year-old man. He has to come to a old age home because his 80-year-old wife died. Okay, so a helper takes him to the elevator and he's describing the room. And the man says, I like it very much. You know, with great enthusiasm of an 8-year-old boy kind of a thing. Then immediately the man says, you haven't even seen the room. Hang on a moment, we are almost there. That was nothing to do with it, he replies, the old man. Room has nothing to do with it. It is already, I decided in my mind, I like my room. It is the decision I take every morning when I wake up. Happiness is something I choose in advance. Whether or not I like the room does not depend on the furniture or the decor. Rather, it depends on how I decide to see it. I can choose, I can spend my day in bed enumerating all the difficulties that I have had with the parts of my body that no longer work very well. Or I can get up and give thanks to heavens for those parts that are still in working order. Every day is a gift, and as long as I can open my eyes, I will focus on the new day and all the happy memories that I have built up during my life. So this is the decision. You know, it's a long-term decision. Why we are doing many things is for our happiness. So I want to end with this story, and thank you very much for your very, very kind and patient hearing and active participation. Thank you.
Let me take the opportunity of thanking you, Dr. Stephen Titus. It was a very informative, explorative, and easy to understand. And I hope that we'll continue to do some more sessions with you. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you very much, Sanjay. I enjoyed it very much also. Thank you very much.